Hello everyone, welcome to my channel High Love Pharmacology. In continuation with the adverse drug reaction series, in today's session we're going to learn about the adverse drug reaction probability scale, in particular with the Naranjo adverse drug reaction probability scale. So let us see some background information about the probability scale. The adverse drug reaction probability scale was developed by Naranjo and his co-workers in 1991 from University of Toronto and is often referred to as Naranjo scale. This scale was developed to help standardize assessment of causality of all adverse drug reactions. And this scale can also be designed for use in control trials as well as registration studies of new medications rather than in routine clinical practice. And this Naranjo scale is very simple to apply and they are widely used across the globe. So the ADR probability score consists of totally 10 questions that are answered as either yes, no, or do not know. So there are different point values ranging from minus 1, 0, plus 1, or plus 2, which are assigned to each answers. So this is the 10 items which are present under the Naranjo adverse drug reaction probability scale. So let us see what are those 10 items. So first question is, are there previous conclusive reports on this reaction? So you can, if it is yes, you need to put plus 1. If it is no and do not know, it is 0, 0. And score has to be put here. So second question is, did the adverse event appear after the suspected drug was administered? If it is yes, you need to put plus 2. If it is no, it is minus 1. If do not know, it is 0. And you need to put the final score here. And third question is, did the adverse event improve when the drug was discontinued or a specific antagonist was administered? If it is yes, you need to put plus 1. And if it is no and do not know, it is 0, 0. And the question 4 is, did the adverse event reappear when the drug was readministered? If it is yes, it is plus 2. If it is no, it is minus 1. And it is 0 for do not know. And fifth question is, are there alternative causes that could on their own have caused the reaction? If it is yes, it will be given minus 1. If it is no, it is plus 2 and 0 for do not know. And question number 6, did the reaction reappear when a placebo was given? If it is yes, it is minus 1. If it is no, it is plus 1 and 0 for do not know. And question number 7 is, was the drug detected in blood or other fluids in concentrations known to be toxic? If it is yes, it is plus 1 and 0 for both no and do not know. Question number 8 is, was the reaction more severe when the dose was increased or less severe when the dose was decreased? If it is yes, it is plus 1 and 0 for both no and do not know. And question number 9, did the patient have a similar reaction to the same or similar drugs in any previous exposure or the past exposure? If it is yes, it is plus 1 and 0 for both no and do not know. And 10th question is, was the adverse event confirmed by any objective evidence? If it is yes, it is plus 1 and 0 for both no and do not know. So once you put the score for each questions and you can totally get the total score from all these 10 questions. So once you get the total score, so you will apply this score for interpretation. So if the score is more than 9 or equal to 9, it means it is definite. So the reaction followed a reasonable temporal sequence after a drug or in which a toxic drug level had been established in body fluid or tissue, or followed a recognized response to the suspected drug and was confirmed by improvement on withdrawing the drug and reappeared on re-exposure. If the total score is between 5 to 8, it is probable. So, reaction followed a reasonable temporal sequence after a drug followed a recognized response to the suspected drug was confirmed by withdrawal but not by exposure to the drug and could not be reasonably explained by the known characteristic of the patient's clinical state. If the score is between 1 to 4, it is possible. So, reaction followed a temporal sequence after a drug, possibly followed a recognized pattern to the suspected drug, could be explained by characteristic of the patient diseases. If the total score is less than or equal to 0, it is doubtful and reaction was likely related to factors other than a drug. So remember, if the total score is less than or equal to 0, the interpretation is doubtful. If the total score is between 1 to 4, the interpretation is possible. And if the total score is between 5 to 8, that means to say the suspected adverse drug reaction is probable. And if the total score is more than or equal to 9, the adverse drug reaction that is suspected is definite. So this was my reference. If you find this video useful, please do subscribe to my channel I Love Pharmacology and do not forget to share and hit the like button and bell icon for more updates on pharmacology. Thank you.